Hello. Not too long ago, we made a video about using old cameras to get good pictures. This video is a demonstration on how to use a relatively inexpensive camera that's currently brand new to take interesting pictures. It gets a tiny bit technical in the middle, but hopefully there's some decent photos at the end, so bear with us. The Raspberry Pi Foundation has released their camera module 3 range. Each of them has a 7.4mm, 12-megapixel Sony sensor, an f1.8 lens, and focus adjustment from 10 centimeters to infinity. They come in 4 flavors. Standard with a 75 degree angle of view, wide with a 120 degree angle of view, and intriguingly, each of these in a version called NoIR. NoIR is what we're most interested in. Here's why. NoIR, or NoIR, is a slightly ironic name because it refers to the fact that the sensor is naked and has no infrared filter, which actually means the sensor picks up lots of infrared light, compared to the other two camera modules, which both have infrared filters. Before we show you the pictures that we took with NoIR, here's a super quick explainer on why the images look the way that they do. The world is bathed in electromagnetic waves that can be arranged on a spectrum of wavelengths that range from short X-rays to long radio waves. In the middle of the spectrum, there's a small range of wavelengths that the human eye can see, and to get an idea of those wavelengths, we need to talk about small distances. A nanometer is a tiny fraction of a meter. There are 1,000 million nanometers in a meter. To give you an idea of how small that is, your fingernails grow a nanometer or two every second. The small portion of the electromagnetic spectrum that human eyes are sensitive to have wavelengths of around 400 to 700 nanometers, about the distance your fingernails grow while you drink a nice cup of tea. We call that collection of waves visible light. Fun fact, bumblebees see waves differently to the waves a human eye sees. A bee's visible light contains less red and more violet and ultraviolet than human visible light. This gives bees an advantage when seeking out nectar, as many patterns on flowers are invisible to humans and can only be seen in ultraviolet light. These nectar bullseyes means finding nectar a breeze for the bees. Back to the camera. The sensors on digital cameras pick up light visible to humans, but they also pick up some infrared light, which we can then see on the image recorded by the camera. So these cameras can make things that are usually invisible, visible. The obvious application to these sensors is night vision, but there is another slightly more artistic application. Most modern cameras have a built-in infrared filter to make sure the images that it records are consistent and what your eye sees. Because the newer camera doesn't have that filter, in theory we should be able to pick up some interesting stuff. We took this NoIR camera and used it with a 720nm filter. This filter blocks out all wavelengths shorter than 720nm. In theory, this leaves us with a camera that sees mostly infrared light and just the edge of the red end of visible colours. Anyway, enough of that, the pictures. Here they are. There's a bit more detail on post-processing the images and the tools we used. All the links are in the description. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching.